So this is Big Dog.
This is about 10 years ago when we started exploring whether or not you could make a dynamic robot that works out in the world. And, you know, our top-level goal is to see if we could build machines that do what people and animals do. And this was a start in that.
What are we looking at now?
This we call Alpha Dog. It's also called the Legged Squad Support System. And it's a robot that can carry about 400 pounds of load and go about 20 miles through very rugged terrain.
This is a very quick robot we're looking at right here.
Yeah, this is the fastest legged robot. That's the Cheetah. And this is Spot. This is a newer robot that we built just over the last 2 years. This robot, as far as I can tell, has the best rough terrain mobility of anything that's ever been built.
The stairs, you know, I don't think people realize how difficult it is to walk
really
up a set of stairs.
This is in Boston, and every stairway is different. None of them are to code. Here we're testing out the idea of whether or not you could do home deliveries, not with drones, but with just plain old legged robots.
So there's a certain amount of control, you know, you'll see in some of these shots, there's somebody standing there. I suspect it's Seth in some of these cases. Holding a laptop, but how autonomous are the robots?
This is really showing autonomy in that there's no one controlling it other than telling it to go ahead. And in this case, one of our engineers is giving it a hard time, and you can see the ability of the robot to stay on target, keep trying to do what we told it to do, which is to get through the door, replanning as it needs to, keeping its balance, and the like.
All right, this obviously presents an entirely different challenge.
Yeah. But it's conceptually the same thing. We're showing that the robot has autonomy. Here, Atlas, which is a humanoid robot, is trying to pick up the box. It's using a visual system to locate the box. It's planning its path to approach it so it can use its legs and its arms and its torso to get at it. And our engineer is giving it a hard time.
Do you ever feel a little bit bad? I mean, it seems like a large number of these videos involve you abusing the crap out of the robots.
You know, I know the media says we're abusing them. We're really like proud parents showing off what the robots can do. Here we took the robot on vacation up in Vermont and we're testing it. It headed right for the bar. But here we're showing it autonomously traversing a cluttered area. No one's driving it there. It looks like it did get to the bar. It's trying to go up to its room. And then we played around with some tasks where the robot and the human worked together.
It's nice. So after all of the hitting it with hockey sticks, this is the coming together.
Right.